So I have a question. Are you becoming a germaphobe? Now listen, I am not against protecting yourself against the coronavirus or any virus at all with a mask or washing your hand, and you need to do that. The point I want to make is this. Not all germs are harmful or dangerous. And I want to make a distinction. Friendly microbes are not pathogenic, okay? So pathogens are those microbes that cause disease. That includes virus, bacteria, fungus, candida, etc. You have as a huge part of your immune system, trillions and trillions of friendly microbes around the surface of your body, inside your body, in your colon. And when you over-sterilize your body, it can lower your immune system and make you more susceptible to having infections. These microbes do so much good. There's certain microbes that make acid that makes a pathogen not want to live in that environment. Your microbes make vitamins to support your immune system. They also have anti-tumor properties. And a lot of people get grossed out when they realize that they have an entire universe of microbes living through the body and your environment. Everywhere you touch, there's microbes, there's germs all over the place. But what they have to realize is when they start to overly destroy the microbes on our body, as well as the microbes in our food, our resistance to infection goes down because these microbes are symbiotic. They actually help form a barrier to protect us. In some interesting studies where they have germ-free mice, they basically have no microbial life living inside or outside that mouse. They end up with autoimmune diseases, allergies, asthma, and all sorts of other health problems. If you look on the surface of your skin, it's not just a layer of dead cells. There are billions of things living on your skin, and I know it's kind of creepy, but that's called skin flora. And this flora is very, very necessary to protecting you. It's an immune defense. When you alter this, what's called microbiome, you basically throw the body out of balance and you start getting inflammatory conditions. Even on the surface of your skin, you can have psoriasis, you can have rosacea, you can even get acne. Over-sterilization of your body leads to a decrease in T cells. And these T cells form the adaptive immunity, which is really, really important in preventing inflammatory reactions throughout the body. Unfortunately, the viewpoint that most people have about germs is very, very negative. They're not very aware of the benefits of these microbes. Even with your food, if you consume too much sterilized food, and I'm talking about food that is pasteurized, whether it's canned or in a bottle, it's heated with high temperatures or killing off everything, including enzymes, or even radiated. They actually use radiation on our food nowadays. And when you eat these foods that are so-called sterilized, it actually creates an immune reaction and it can actually weaken our immune system. In summary, the point about this video is that you have to realize that you are born with an incredibly complex, sophisticated immune system, way more powerful as compared to any type of military that ever was on this planet. Your immune system, if you maintain it and you keep it healthy, can defend you against just about any attack from any virus or bacteria on this planet. And this is why the strategic advantage of a virus is that it can invade someone with a compromised immune system, but it can have an extreme disadvantage and a very hard time infecting someone with a strong immune system. So if you want more information about how to boost your immune system, I put it right here.